Hello everyone, today we're taking a look at the MouseMX Windows virus Trojan thing. This was requested and submitted by a viewer named Pryon through my email back in January, so I'm sorry this took me so long to actually finally take a look at. Let me just say, I want to express my appreciation for the level of effort this person went through. They researched, dug through articles for a long time based off of a fragment of a memory they had about a virus based on cheese. They finally found it, and then they went the extra mile. They actually went out and found a sample and sent that virus to me, which I can now show to you, which is great because this virus is hilarious. You see, most of the time, people have these ideas or these memories in their heads of some virus they encountered 20, 30 years ago, and they ask me if I know what it is based on some vague list of symptoms or problems that they noticed with their computer, and most of the time, unless it's something really famous, the answer is no. There's just so many obscure ones that don't have articles written about them, it's impossible to find. But Pryon did so much of the legwork, made this so much easier, so thank you. So you can see here, we have a bunch of exe files. Just standard Windows EXEs, just renamed a couple times. We got RegEdit, we got Calculator, we got Dr. Watson with his stupid face. Just generally trying to represent a computer that's been well used. Also got some MP3s here of the Mega Man 9 soundtrack. And, you know, I'm a huge nerd. That's what I listen to. And then over here on our desktop, or I mean in our my computer, I've got my games, which have all of the same EXEs, just segmented into different folders. So imagine this is a well-used computer with EXEs strewn about in multiple folders. All right, it figures right when I start getting back into the swing of things making videos again, the camera battery dies, so I have to swap it out. So that's enough of my explanations. Thanks again to Pryon for all the legwork. Let's take a look at what MouseMX actually does. So I'm gonna get this window out of the way, and now I'm just gonna run it, and we'll see what happens. So, apparently, nothing happens. However, of course, if you've watched this channel for any length of time, we know something has probably happened. Let's take a look at the Windows directory. It's supposed to make a hidden folder somewhere in here. Alright, I took a look around for a while. I didn't see it yet, so we're just going to run this virus a few more times. Oh, did you see that? So, you might notice that a couple of our icons are now cheese. So we have HHEXE and Clean Manager EXE replaced with cheese. They still function. However, this program has been entirely replaced with the MouseMX virus, and its original EXE has been moved to a hidden directory. Let's see if we can find it. Ideally, yep, it's right here on the root called MouseMX. It's a hidden folder, so in standard settings you wouldn't be able to see this. If we open it up, we can see this is what MouseMX does. It starts to harvest executable files, MP3s, also AVI and other files on your PC, and starts to hoard them into this folder right here. So you notice we have some of the same programs stored in here. There's a lot with the same names, which kind of makes me concerned, because if you have programs dependent on a certain executable being in a certain place, but there's a similarly or exactly named exe somewhere else on the drive, what happens when those both get copied by MouseMX into that directory? How will you know which one's the right one? Anyway, now if we run these infected cheese files, it should, ideally, start collecting more files from them, until eventually our entire computer is nothing but wheels of cheese. We see Notepad is now gone, but it still functions. Free cell. For now, we still have good old Solitaire. It's not exactly the classic, it's got that updated Windows XP icon, but still Solitaire that we know and love. For my MP3s, I tried to get FUBAR 2000, but this is such an old version of Windows XP, it won't even install, so oh well. Oh, we see in our games folder one of our command prompt executables was replaced. How about in here? Oh, Dr. Watson's gone. Anything else? Oh, yep. We're slowly but surely starting to infiltrate every directory. Now, thankfully, MouseMX does avoid the Windows directory, so it can't just totally annihilate Windows by replacing files from there. I'm excited to see if it picks up some of these MP3s. It's supposed to get a bunch of movie files, MP3s, all that sort of stuff, but I haven't seen that yet. Well, this one seems to be running for a little while longer. It got Program Manager. Now, I'm not sure if Windows is just stuck with the hourglass icon or what, but oh, there goes Solitaire. Okay, I was just mentioning Solitaire was still good, but no longer. Regedit. Slowly but surely. We are cheesifying this PC. Command, oh no, command's still good, but our foobar 2000 installation file is now cheese. Have any MP3s been taken yet? Not yet. I'd really like to see that. Okay, I guess we are just stuck with this hourglass. It makes me think like the computer's thinking super hard about what it's doing, but apparently not. So I'm just gonna spam click this. And you can see it wouldn't take very long for a heavy computer user to completely just infiltrate their entire PC with nothing but cheese. Alright, I'm not sure if that's actually getting anything. I don't see any desktop icons changing, or if they are, I'm not noticing them. Well, this has actually found some other exes from other directories that I did not make dummy copies of, so it's certainly going out and finding what it can. And thankfully it does look like it avoids copying more than one executable of the same name, so that might explain why we're not seeing the entire computer being just overtaken with cheese. Now I have an idea. Will Rover show me a bunch of cheese icons? Oops, no, stop. I didn't mean to press that. You know what? No, go back, back, back. Let's try this again. Okay. Yes, he will. So, Rover is being particularly helpful in showing me all the cheese on my PC. Looks like the further down we scroll, I don't see any more cheese. Oh, I spoke too soon. I saw a bunch. There we go. So this is in the gateway program files folder, covered in cheese. And this, in a nutshell, is all that MouseMX does. It's one of those classic mid-2000s, just annoying, weird pieces of malware. It's kind of in that interim period between when we went from extremely destructive viruses like CIH, widespread worms like Love Letter, to the current day where we started seeing more info stealers, banking trojans, stuff like that that lays low, but not MouseMX. It's purely mischief. And I am disappointed we did not see it get any of these MP3s. I'm going to put this right in here and start running it in this directory because, come on. Cheese MP3s would be great. Alright, doesn't look like it's happening. It's unfortunate, but it is what it is. Now, you, the end user, are tasked with cleaning up MouseMX's directory trash. How do you know where each one of these actually came from? Hopefully you know your computer inside and out, because if you didn't know some of these were just in random program files folders, how are you going to fix it? Do you know where this setup exe came from? How about setup 50.exe or sapisvr.exe? And you know what? Now that I say that, I'm about 90% certain somebody's going to come out of the woodwork and leave a comment saying, I know exactly where that comes from, Dan. Which is why I usually try to avoid these sort of challenging questions where I'm insinuating you probably don't know, because odds are somebody does. Alright, one last thing to look at. So this virus, Trojan, whatever it is, spreads not only through cheese on your PC, but also seeks out Kazaa if you have it installed. Because, of course, where else would this virus come from? Using names like GTA Crack or Norton Antivirus, spelled with a Y, full version 2005. It's really just the ultimate mid-2000s malware. I see without having Kazaa installed, it did not set itself as a special directory to help spread MouseMX, which is a shame. Probably should have installed it beforehand, but we do see MouseMX2 added here to the software in the current user's key, where we see version 1.1, type virus, name MouseMX, infection, which is taken from the date that you originally ran this on your computer. Seems like it was written in late 2004 from Poland. Seems like every time we see Polish malware on this channel, it's something funny and off the wall, and you generally don't see it in a lot of other malware. And MouseMX is no exception. So that's all I have to say about MouseMX. Thanks, Pryon, for all your help in getting me prepared to make this video. Sorry it took so long. Thank you for watching. I always appreciate having you here and reading your wonderful comments and the not so wonderful comments. I'm just happy you keep showing up. So, to sign off, that's about it for the MouseMX Windows virus. Thank you very much for watching. Take care.